My name is Surjendra Goswami. I work as a senior staff engineer at Seagate Technology. My responsibility is to lead the signal integrity team and ensure that none of the boards are having any defects related to signal performance. As a designer, I would like to recommend that the best practice should be to start from the pre-layout stage, generate the constraints, do a constraint-driven routing with the layout team, and finally, as a sign-off, use the post-layout simulation results and the report for finally closing on the design. My latest project is based on the M.2 form factor. The product is targeted for the storage SSD enterprise market. So the M.2 form factor is 22mm by 110mm only. And with this shrunk form factor and the components on the board, we just barely have space to route. With this, it is really a challenge to meet all of the signal integrity performance. And with that, I have to meet all of the parameters for each of the interfaces, which is DDR, which is ONFI, as well as the NVMe interface. And I have to do that in a very short time as well to meet our time to market commitments. And I have to make sure also that the yield for this design is good enough to make sure that our cost overruns are minimal. We started with the pre-layout simulation, and during this simulation, we actually find out what is the best topology for us for a particular bus. We finalize the stack up, the target impedance for or and the spacing, what we are trying to achieve. Following this, we have, as output of this stage, we have the constraints which are available for us and the layout team. So we pass on these constraints to the layout team for them for the design implementation. And when they are doing the constraint-driven routing on Allegro, so then these come in a very, very, very handy for them. After the design implementation and is done, the layout is available for us for doing the extraction. So we have the PowerSI extraction tool, and on that, it is really easy for us to set up the simulation extraction itself with the auto port setup, and with the hybrid solver, the timelines is also very, very minimal while doing the extraction. These characteristics, the S parameters, are then used on the system SI to simulate the whole bus. On the system SI, we have a very good tool in the sweep manager, where we are able to run through all of the sweeps and find out what exactly is working for our bus and nail down the key setting for our bus. The post layout simulation on the system SI tool, after we generate the reports for that, after the simulation are done, so that system SI report has a wealth of information. The system SI tool gives out what are the timing margins available for this bus. Apart from this, it also lists out the best and the worst case scenarios based on these timing margins. After the post layout simulation, the hardware measurement results also show a very good correlation with the simulated results. The Allegro and the system SI platform has been really very useful for us. The benefits that we see directly from this toolset are in terms of the ease of use, flexibility for different types of inputs, and exchanging information between the Allegro and the system SI toolset. Also, the correlation is very good with the measurement results, and the experience has really been fantastic so far.